What's good, guys? It's your boy Clint Wolf, the Mobile Messiah, and bruh, Dark Magician Beth, the baddie of the Invader Overworld. Oh my goodness, she is about to come to the game and absolutely wreck shop, bruh. I have a feeling. We're about to talk about that and much, much more, including the damn big gacha machine. And oh my goodness, the goodies in there are so magnificent. Oh, but before we get started, let me show some love to my patron sponsors. We got Johnny, we got Teddy, we got No Select Dax, we got Raylander, we got Kamen Ray, and most recently, we got the homie Solomon Chung. Back at it again. You may remember him from sponsoring a video a couple videos back on one of our summons videos for a future prince. So let's not talk about that. Anyways, let's get into the video.
Jingle bells, woof miss hails, I'm posting all the way to Christmas Eve. I do this thing, I got it all day. Back for some more Guardian Tales. I'm about to do this review because Dark Magician Beth is gonna wreck you. Ha ha ha, she is gonna go crazy. She is super OP. I hope you enjoy this song by the homie Johnny. Ha ha ha.
I wanna do one of those like song openings when you light like a lighter. It sound like I'm lighting a blunt. That'll be fresh. Yeah. It wouldn't even be me if I didn't make a scene. That's why I'm about to kill it in a minute 16. My bars erupt oceans, these dudes are mainstream. If the kid is so nice, why I'm looking so mean? It's cause I'm hungry, yeah, my cake is looking spongy. I know if I eat a lot, to the top it's gonna lunge me. Don't need your niggas to fund me, you dirty, so looking grungy. Know the devil may cry for my halo, but no Bungie or Microsoft. I'm falling off, fuck all your heads, I'm sawing off as soon as I get your keys. You know my ass is hauling off, all your shots be calling off. Get eaten up like shrugging off. If you coming at us, best believe I'll be stalling off. I always been a fighter, a poet and then a writer. Dragonborn with all the fire, nigga, you can keep your lighter, I could pull an all-nighter. My skill is ample. For example, did you notice I just trampled the sample? Beep, and shamer Adonis. If we didn't meet, if you step in my kitchen, guess I'm about to eat. Cause I butcher y'all niggas, y'all nothing but meat or flesh or whatever, you're facing defeat. Sentient organisms with their fucking lack of wisdom on a Katy Perry flow, got you living in a prism. A ism from cataclysm, taking over capitalism, leading campaigns of radicalism. Shout out Jersey on the change up, we trying to get our change up. If y'all niggas can't see us, nigga, you should get your range up. A flow of a dick penetrating so sick, I'm about to go viral. Hate to sneeze right quick, I'm back on my grind. They know that I'm a skater, I'm already up the block. Fuck you, I see you later. I think that was good.
I think that was damn good too. Make sure y'all give the homie J Murr a look. I'm gonna leave his information down in the comments and stuff like that in the description. He is a Patreon supporter, bro, so y'all make sure to check the homie out. That was fire. But let's talk about this update for KR. As you can see, we have 4 different heroes available in the pickup summon, including this monster here. We have Dark Magician Beth available, guys, and her EX weapon is instantly going to wipe out the assumed advantage that people think light element heroes are going to have on her. Yes, they will have an advantage while attacking her, but we're going to talk about why that's not going to be that strong. But her weapon is going to make her disadvantage from attacking those heroes pretty much null and void, because it's going to lower the resistance of dark element attacks of the enemy that she attacks with that weapon by 20%, guys. So light element heroes are only going to have a natural plus 10% advantage on her when she's attacking them. All right, so that advantage is pretty much out the window. And at this point, we're just looking at the kit. We're looking at the kit. Unfortunately, I don't have enough gems to kind of go crazy and try to summon her, nor can I will out on my KR account. This is a completely free-to-play account, so we just have to get her through mileage or something like that, through the big gacha. We'll talk about that in a second. But right now, let's take a look at this kit. First of all, her attack is higher than heroes like Ogma, and the reason I say Ogma is because her defense is higher than Ogma's, guys. Ogma's defense is like 188 at 74. Hers is 204. Ogma does, however, have like 4,000 more HP, but she has more attack by like 100 than Ogma. So instantly, she is essentially like a DPS slash kind of tank resistance type hero, guys. And then you look at her damn exclusive weapon, and oh my goodness, like we already talked about the dark resistance, but then if you use her regular attack, you get a 10% shield constantly. That is insane. I don't see a cooldown for it, Maybe we will see the cool down when we get a chance to actually use her over on Global when she releases, because I'm going to mileage her instantly. I'm not even going to summon her. I'm mileaging her instantly on Global, guys. And this is nuts. So let's take a look at the rest of this stuff. All right, so you see her party ability is going to be that melee attack plus 50%. That's going to make heroes like Agma, like any, pretty much all these recent heroes have been releasing, are going to get a major buff from her. That is a really good party buff, because that means she does not have to only be on Dark Element teams. And her basic attack is going to be called the Dark Smash. Remember, we just talked about that exclusive weapon. When Dark Smash is used, she gets a 10% shield, guys. So that's her normal attack. Dark Smash is her normal attack. That's crazy. And then we have her chain skill is going to do a really good amount of damage at 400%. And it actually does 400% of ranged damage. So that's going to be a little misleading. And that may be want to be something you address when you're thinking about equipping her with different cards or whatever you want to do, equipments. You want to address that in some kind of way as far as getting up that ranged attack, because her chain skill does activate off of ranged attack, guys. But afterwards, it's going to buff her melee attack for 8 seconds, which is really weird. That's a really weird combination chain skill, but it is what it is. And in her special ability, something I really, really like, this is going to make her an absolute terror in the Colosseum. The more enemies around her, she can potentially negate damage altogether with a 60% chance, or raise her attack by 15% depending on how many enemies are around. So a maximum of 4 enemies in the Colosseum, she can get a 60% attack buff if everyone's trying to dogpile her. So she can essentially end up being a solo carry in the freaking Colosseum. So let's pause on that. We're going to talk more about her in her own video when I do summon her on Global, or when I get a chance to use her. We're going to talk about that. But let's look at this damn big gacha event. This big gacha event is way better than I thought it was going to be. It's way better than any event they have put in this game. No, it is not a regular event where you just have to use stamina up and you will be able to farm the event. You will actually have to complete daily event missions to farm the tokens needed for these big gacha events. And as you can see, guys, the prize list for these gachas is impressive. Yes, there's percentages, low percentages for stuff, but hey, you have about 14 days to take advantage of an event like this, which means you have all the time in the world to at least get something. You're gonna get something. You're not gonna get completely shafted if you're only summoning on one of these gachas or whatever, however you wanna do it, you should get it. And then either way, you're gonna be getting these empty gacha shells. If you don't get anything, or whenever you summon, you get these empty gacha shells and you'll be able to use those to purchase a legendary EX mileage box. All right, so like I said, let's take a look at the event missions that you can do. It's just different stuff like cleaning out Heaven Hole, buy a shop item, doing your resource dungeon, participate in Colosseum, summoning heroes, summoning equipment. So you do need to do at least 6 summons on each anyways on Dark Beth. So budget for that to have about 12 summons worth of gems around the time this event comes around, guys. But after you do that, you'll come back over to the big gacha, use it. I'm gonna go completely on this gem because I'm really trying to summon Beth on my KR account just so I can hurry up and use her. I want to really use her and get a feel for her so I can really give you guys like my ultimate judgment of whether or not I think she's going to be a meta breaking unit. It really looks like it right now, because the one advantage that heroes have against her is completely gone. Light element heroes, that is gone. She can attack you and do just as much damage as she would do against anybody else, and you can attack her and potentially not do any damage to her, especially in the Colosseum. She is going to dominate the Colosseum rankings, probably alongside Agma. I'm calling it. But stay tuned, I'm gonna drop a video on Baseball Girl Yuri next. If you're looking to take your support to the next level, then consider joining Clint Wolf's Pack Leaders over on Patreon. Here, you'll gain access to new exclusive content only available for my patrons, including vlogs, story time, and community voted mobile gaming coverage, guys. This is a great deal. And get this, guys, I even have an entire tier dedicated to helping other creators get their channels up off the ground using any of the tips I've picked up along the way myself. For more information, check out the link in the description below.